Earthquake may well be the beginning of the end.
Welcome to JDM Insider, Volume 2 in Yokohama. We are your host, Hiro.
And I'm your other host, Toshi. We're going to take you deep inside the street racing world this time. Live it as we experience it. Let's go.
Let's go.
Sweet ass cars.
Yeah, we have a GTR,
Supra Z, GTRs. Porsche. Where are we?
Top secret, man.
Top secret. Why didn't you tell me? Where are we?
Top secret. That's the name of the shop.
Oh, right. Top secret.
Right, exactly.
That explains this big ass sign that we're standing in front of. I know these guys. Street, drag, drift. These guys have done it. Top speed. Yep. Speaking of top speed, that's what's the owner's name again?
Smokey
Nagata.
It's a Smokey.
It's crazy. What was the deal with him again?
Well, supposedly, like unofficially, he got caught while he was driving over 200 miles on the freeway in the UK, and his ass got sent into jail.
I heard about that, dude. Yeah. That's crazy. All right, there's got to be a reason for his name being Smokey.
Smokey, yeah.
So, and I doubt it's cigarettes. So let's go check him out. Let's go see if he's here.
Yeah. Let's find out. I'm in the showroom of Top Secret. Let's find out what they have in stock and what they sell. And these are the exhaust system, the original product of Top Secret, R34. Yeah, this is a titanium exhaust system. I think most of the exhaust systems are titanium. Oh, check this out. Sweet, that's the drag. RB26 engine. Nice. Well, as you might know, the gold color is a signature color of Top Secret. Oh, this is a famous video, the option video. Yeah, the Drifting is really, you know, popular for almost 10 years. And the US, we just got the D1 Grand Prix last August. And that Drifting is really getting popular and popular. Oh my god, look at this. They have JDM Insider too. And the Top Secret is known for making the body kits also. And these carbon fiber pieces, the rear diffuser, are the Top Secret original. And I think they have two different colors. This kind of yellowish carbon and the black carbon. And as you know, Auto Tuner Shop has like affiliation with Apex, HKS, and Grady, Blitz. So as you can see, like all that performance stuff is on the shelf. So okay, so this was the showroom for the Top Secret. Let's check out the garage area, the work pit.
This is one of the cars that started it all. JZ80 Supra twin turbo. What's wrong here? It's an RB26. This is off a Skyline. Skyline GTR engine transplanted into a JZ80. We're looking at probably a T78 ready turbo. I would assume it's pushing probably upwards of, with this, maybe 600 to 700 horsepower. We are now looking at the inside of the JZ80 Supra. As you saw earlier, this is the one with the RB26 engine. Now, if that makes no sense to you, we're looking at the Supra with the Nissan Skyline engine in it. want to go over some of the points on the interior. One of the main things that's interesting about this is the high level of tuning that we have for street cars in Japan. They're using a stacked gauge monitor, which is used in a lot of track racing cars, custom carbon fiber, back plate. For the fuel management, in this particular one we're using standalone fuel management, but it's mounted in the dashboard in a custom leather covered case so that you can plug in the data logger, you can plug in the laptop without having to take off the kick panel. Good supportive seats, but reclining so that you can get in and out of the car easily. Custom flush mounted LCD monitor screen. Obviously that's for audio visual, but it could very well be connected to other diagnostic systems. Because we're using a Skyline engine, obviously we have a Skyline transmission. I think on this one, it's got a custom shift knob. I don't know who makes it, but it could be a Hollinger or maybe a Gredi 6-speed transmission. But either way, it's got to be upgraded to handle over 600 horsepower. Moving right along the next car. Over here. These guys don't like anything conventional, obviously. It's a VQ engine that people say that you can't really do anything to. Obviously, they've done a lot to it. It is turbocharged, custom intake manifold, blow-by plenum, your usual assortment of goodies. Why work on a VQ? It's because the VQ is probably the next big thing from Nissan. The new GTR is probably going to use it. Inline sixes, they don't pass smog. Our friend Hiro would know a lot about that, having a lot of problems with that. It's a great engine, but Nissan from now on, they're going to go for the compact V6 motors, which brings us to the next thing. If they're all going to be V6s, you got to start working on V6s. BNR34, another thing, what's wrong here? Nothing's wrong. We've got a VQ engine that's transplanted. This is probably the 3-liter motor. It's got stronger connecting rods. It's a better platform, but the reason why they build demo cars like this is so that when the new GTR comes out, they're one step ahead. I want to show you guys something here. What does this look like? This does not belong here. This is a Del Sol, but it's just a sport compact Spokon style, re-imported into Japan, Fast and Furious style. It's got the color coordinated seats, the gaudy cell phone holder, the chrome shift knob. Stop! Ah! Clear tail light. Oh my god! Everything was fine until I saw this. Please don't do this anymore. Let's not import this to Japan. Stop it.
Finally, we find this Mr. Smokey Nagata. And I think currently he's tuning the GTR. And as soon as he finishes the car, we're going to go to a street racing on the top speed. And a couple Supra, a couple GTR, and some other car will be there. So please stay tuned. Here we go. Now we have another JZ880 Supra, and oh my gosh, actual owner of this car is the girl.
Hello, nice to meet you.
And my name is Ayumi.
Konnichiwa, konnichiwa. So, this is your car?
Yeah.
This has to be your boyfriend's car.
No way. This is a Supra that I adore.
When a girl drives a sports car like a Supra, don't you get into so much trouble? Especially a fixed-up car like this. For example, a guy tailgating you?
Yes, a lot of times the guys tailgate me.
What do you do when you get tailgated?
Well, I just floor it and get away. And then I wait until the guys pass me by and then I tailgate them back.
Oh, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth.
Of course.
So basically, Top Secret did all the work for you?
Yeah, I leave everything up to Top Secret.
So do you get a discount from Top Secret because you're a girl?
Well...
Between you and me...
That's Top Secret.
Why don't you describe the modifications a little?
Stock engine, stock turbo, just increased boost. It's making about 460 horsepower. The top speed was recorded at 270 kilometers per hour.
Were you driving the car at 270 kilometers per hour?
That was for the magazine shoot. For a Japanese magazine called Option 2.
Oh yeah, I know that magazine.
Yes, please take a look at that magazine.
Do you mostly drive this car on the street?
Yeah.
Do you go to the street races or track events often?
Sometimes. When I go to the circuit, I readjust my suspension.
When I was talking to you earlier, you mentioned that you were a model. Do you do modeling at the Tokyo Auto
Salon?
Yeah,
sometimes.
We'll be at the Tokyo Auto Salon next year too. See you there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Hey, what's up? I'm Orido, pro race driver. Anyways, I usually run the Denso SAR GT500 Supra in the JGTC Racing Series as a Toyota Works driver. You guys watching may know me better as one of the official D1 Grand Prix judges. Through D1 Grand Prix, I kept drifting and before I knew it, I built this house. Take a look, my new house. I just built it, but it's not done yet. Welcome to the Orido House. Well, anyways, this is my entrance. Unlike America, Japanese entrances have a step. Another difference? You take your shoes off. And please, wear slippers. Got it? Don't come in with your shoes on. Wear slippers before coming in. The first impression you get is a racer. A racer. See how I put all my helmets here? The legendary ones. This helmet is the one I used in America when I raced NASCAR. This is a Simpson helmet. And an Arai helmet. This is a super plastic model that I got in America. Welcome to my living room. It's not too big, but this is my TV. I took out a loan for this TV when I bought my house. So at night, when I turn down the lights, and my family has gone to sleep, I just work the sofa like this, and it even reclines farther like this. It's really comfortable. And I put my sake right here. This is the first area that I really got into. Please, take a look. It might be common in America.
Open terrace.
The reason why I built it, I know it's common to have barbecues, but I built it to party with my friends. It's not complete yet, so it's a little dirty. Terrace. So on to my favorite spot. This dining table. This was something I wanted and wanted for so long. This was pretty expensive. It's an antique. This is part two. I designed my floor plan just for this table. Since we saw my dining room, let's go look at the kitchen. Don't you think it's weird that I have a computer in the dining room? Japanese stuff is crazy. This also turns into a TV. While cooking, if you spin it like this, you can watch TV while cooking. And you can work on the PC on this side. This is the Orido fridge. Orido style. Take a look. I only have common things in here. For instance, you gotta have beer, sake, vegetable juice, and milk. My frying pan. This is... when I'm at home, I use this to cook. My frying pan. One of my favorite items. Got it? This is my kitchen. Oops, I almost forgot. This guy.
My pet.
His name is Sylvia. Do you know? Named after the car? Sylvia? I just got him when I was deeply in love with the car. His nickname is Sil. He's a good dog, even though he's a guy. He's the only other male in this household. Okay, now let's go to my favorite point. Let's go. Here we are at my favorite point, part 3, my manly room, my basement. Here's the uniform I used when I raced NASCAR in America. Here's the office. This is where I do all my work. This is where I stock all the videos I'm in, and also where I put all my toys on display. So out of my many trophies, this has been my most memorable one. This guy.
1998,
the Mirage 1 Make Race. In the racing world, this race is considered the gateway to becoming a professional driver. And this is where I won the championship. And because of this win, I've been able to do a lot of things. This is a very important trophy.
Yo, this is my ride. This is Supra, né? My Redox Supra.
It's cool, huh? I built this garage just to house the Supra. Do you want to hear the sound? I guess I can let you listen. It's a little loud, though. This is my Supra. Take a look. Are you ready? It's taking on a new life, my Supra. How do you like the sound? My car goes over 186 miles per hour. I built this garage just to park this car. Nice, huh? And next, are you ready? This is my second favorite ride. I think I'll just turn on the engine too. I wonder if it'll start. Hold on a sec. This ain't gonna start. This is no good. Anyways, this is the bike that I always use.
faster bike.
This is truly my favorite spot.
My garage.
Right on, JDM Insider. Thanks for checking out my crib. Unfortunately for you, I'm hungry. I'm starving. I'm gonna go eat dinner, so get the hell out of here. You got enough footage? Go home! Thanks for coming from America. But I'm hungry, so I'll see ya. Have sweet dreams.
Some of the world's top drifters, some of the world's top video photographers, and some of the world's most influential industry people, all in one of the world's toughest mountains on a Friday night. You'd film JDM Insider. That's what we're gonna do. We have a 600 horsepower Soarer, 400 horsepower S15, 15 other cars that just came from Hearsay. They run across the street to Mr. Ueno and they go, "Can we watch you run today?" Two D1 drivers, 400 horsepower chasers. Takahashi's here, everybody's here. We're gonna kick some ass. We have a problem here. There's a territorial dispute. Why did you bring cameras into our territory? Why are you guys shooting? And they sent scouts out to sort of interfere with what we're gonna do. So we basically drove up the mountain. We have a couple of in-car cams going, but we've already seen one police car. We cannot have you guys or the camera guys on the side of the road because one, it's all cliffs along the side. You can't hide anywhere. Number two, if we leave, we're gone for good. Number three, the bashers might come back. And it's very common. So we pulled up all the way up the mountain to this area. We're gonna see about putting some of the camera guys into the other D1 cars instead of the NOAA. You know, all these lights, there's cars all up and down the street. Supposedly somebody sent a chain email out and all the younger kids are all coming out to see, you know, TNE run or whatever. See, and there's just spy cars everywhere here. So anyways, yeah, we've got so many people here. We just broke off with our main crew. We're gonna just go shoot, run, and leave. Now, as far as Ueno's car, he's even impressive. It's running really fast. It's gripping a lot. He has Neova tires on it, but we brought used ones and it's still too much. So he has to kick the clutch to come out. And that's because D1 cars are built for high speed drifting. So they'll make it so that it doesn't slide. When you come to the narrow roads and it's too much. It turns into grips, you know, grip running, and he's having to kick the clutch out. So we're gonna go up the mountain. We're gonna go actually closer to where the grip racers are. But for right now, you know, we've got the 600 horsepower car, we've got all the in-car cams, we've got a bunch of girl drifters here. We're gonna make the best of it. You don't know what's gonna happen on the street, so we'll keep you updated.
Thank you.
tonight. We had a really good time and a great performance.
We want to thank Mr. Ueno and everybody that came out here for an awesome night at the street races.
Guys, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Yay!
It's 4 o'clock in the morning, Sunday, and we are going to a racetrack today. It's called Nikko Circuit, and they have a track event sponsored by Kazama Auto. And today we are taking a D1 car from a Vertex, and Mr. Ueno is going to do a demo run today. And we're gonna go shoot his car and also a customer's car. And I think we have a chance to ride on Mr. Reno's D1 car. So check it out.
If the drifting was 60% full power, because, you know, we had to make it back, and this is gonna be 80%.
80 to 90%. So you should see a lot of good action today. If I could stay awake.
Yeah, we are the Nikko Circuit finally. And look at all the cars. We even have a Porsche and a Ferrari. By the way, that's my Ferrari. I just bought it in Japan because we didn't have a ride.
You like my car? You're gonna see some action from me today. This whole time, it wasn't him driving, it was me. I do this video stuff on the weekends.
Today, this is just a track day, it's not the racing, and we have a couple different sections, grip, A, B, C, D, and also the drift, A, B, C, D. Basically, A means the beginner, and B is intermediate, I is advanced, and D is almost professional. And as you can see, like, the people are like having fun over here at the racetrack, and yeah, some cars really going really fast. Yeah, it's so loud, but this is a drift class A. So these guys are beginners, just start drifting. And as you can see, drift is really getting popular. All the guys are actually watching it. I want to look at it right there. So I'm left wondering.
Yeah!
Okay.
Okay, how was it? How was it, Touge?
The Kazama Auto Tuning Drift Festival. I think that's what it translates to.
Yeah.
How was it?
I mean, speechless. Actually, this was the first time for me to ride on like
you
professional
did all the work
driver.
Today, huh? You did all the work today. You were doing all the interviews.
Kind of interviews.
I know a good thing when I see it. I didn't do crap. All I did was sit in the car and ride with Mr. Ueno. That thing's crazy.
Yeah, it was crazy. How was it though?
It was like a slick car. Well, you said it was a slick car.
Yeah, it was like it.
It's, you know, he takes the clipping point like three corners before. Like when I was in it, if I was driving, I'd be like, okay, now. But he's like three way before that. And you're like, oh, he's not gonna make it. And the car goes bam, bam, bam. Dude. I don't know. I mean, we put so many different camera angles on it today. Like, how many times did we change it? Like, four?
About four or five times.
Yeah, so we, you know, by the time, you know, you guys see this, you'll see all the different angles. You know, you see the tire's flexing, the smoke coming out. We had Mike way out in the back of the screen. I mean, Mr. Kazama was totally cool today, letting us, you know, film everywhere. Mr. Ueno was totally cool. He was sleeping. We were all sleeping on the floor, sleeping in the car.
Yep, all over the place.
At 3 in the morning, and 3 hours of sleep, but it was totally worth it.
Wait a second. The guy is actually passed by.
Well, that usually happens during live filming, yeah. Too, so it's okay.
It's okay.
But this was this year's D1 car. 460 horsepower. How did it feel compared to the 600 horsepower one, the Blitz one?
The Blitz one actually...
I thought it was a little bit more peaky.
Yeah,
this one
so.
Was like, yeah. Anywhere he floored it, it was smooth. I mean, yeah. I wasn't driving, so I wouldn't know, but... this one's like silky smooth, like...
Right.
Elegant,
right.
Elegant movement.
But did you notice though, like... Well, he said he was really, like, you know, driving hard. But I didn't really notice anything. Like,
and I'll bet you guys probably, if you just saw the way the car's moving, it was just...
The transition in the car was so smooth, you know?
I think it's because it's a big car. I mean, he knows how to power it through. I mean, I would love to see him drive an FD and see how much he could do, you know? I mean, you figure part of it is for his character, part of it is for, you know, business or whatever, but, you know, if you drove an S15 or an FD in the series, that'd be pretty good.
Right.
You were talking about what? Like, all the drivers are almost the same level?
Yeah.
So how do you win?
Yeah, I guess so. It really depends on what kind of... Number one, I think the car. You know, the setup is correctly. The tuning is correctly.
And luck.
And luck. Well, I don't know. Is it luck?
I don't know. I don't think so. Not. These guys have been doing it for so long. I mean, you and I were saying, yeah, we're going to get a Hachi and we're going to, you know, really go out there and really practice. But no, dude. The more I ride with them, the more I just lost cause. Oh, and another cool thing about this event is that there were grip racers and drift racers, both sharing the track.
Yeah, sharing the track.
And you could totally tell the difference in the way that the cars are built. I mean, what, the grip racers are a little bit more, what, conservative? I mean, you've got a 460
compared to drifting, compared to drifting, like, grip thing is, like, really conservative.
Yeah, but, you know, I'm really glad we came out here today.
Yeah,
I mean, once
definitely.
Again, we want to thank Kazama Auto for, you know, allowing us to run on last minute notice. We want to thank Mr. Ueno for, you know, getting his ass up and driving us down here. He's been driving us everywhere, every single night. And we are bringing this to you guys. And so, you know, hopefully we don't use up all of our friends. But what time is it now?
It is about 3 o'clock.
Time to party, dude. Okay, well anyways,
well, I guess
to head
beer's
on
waiting,
here.
So
we
gotta
thank
go.
Thank you guys for coming out. We're out of here.
All right, thanks.
I'm gonna give you another tip. Like, this is like little things, but the reason why you shouldn't smoke, I show you a demonstration. See that nicotine right here? This nicotine is get to your lung. This is how fuck... I'm sorry. This is how bad it is for your health. So you should stop smoking.
My name is Takahiro Ueno. My company is called T&E. My company was established on October 10th, 1996. The origin of the company name, as you can see on our decals. T stands for technical, and E stands for elegance. Technical and elegance is almost like the motto of my company. While I was still establishing the company, I suffered a lot of hardship. Well, especially for the first year, I couldn't eat. I had no income coming in, plus I had no money to spend. So my friends noticed what I'd been going through. So they asked me to go out to eat. In reality, I couldn't go out with them because I didn't have any money. I didn't tell them I didn't have any money. Instead of telling the truth, I told them I had other plans. So they were really concerned about me. They thought something might have happened. Because they made up a lame excuse like, they won money, and they forced me to go out and eat. That's how I used to survive. I didn't have a place to live. There's a little back room in our showroom. That's where I'd been sleeping. That went on for about 6 months. Of course, there was no salary for me for the first 3 years. That's how I managed myself and the company. The drifting practice during my hardship, especially during the company's beginning stages, I didn't have money for gas. I couldn't drive the car to practice at all. Even drifting and circuit racing. I couldn't participate in any of the events. After about 6 months, the company started to flow by itself. Then, I started to produce our body kits. I was finally able to drive the car for marketing purposes for my body kits. Until that time, I wasn't able to drive the car at all. I studied by myself. The way I produce the body kits is to look at the cars. The shape of the car inspires the design. My concept is to be simple and aggressive at the same time. There's the original design of the car, right? I don't want to interfere with that design. For example, the fenders are shaped a certain way, and the rest of the body has to follow that shape. So, my kits don't look completely aftermarket. So the concept of my kits are subtle, in that sense. Since I'm still a street racer, I can hear the voice of the street. I want to produce a kit reflecting that voice. I kind of feel like I want to graduate from street racing. Sometimes, I still get the craving to go back to the street, so I go. Yes, it can be seen as anti-society. I think that's why people get addicted to that. One of the fundamentals is to love driving the cars. Although there are many restrictions and obstacles, we all love driving the cars. There's also the thrill and excitement that motivates us to go back to the street. If there's a spot that's never been heard of, that excites me. I'm willing to go there. I try to go to the spot where I can have fun. Usually, I'll go there by myself. But there will be a gathering, so back in the day, I went there with my team. We had 46 members. So we gathered up and then went. Well, when we go to a spot, we litter. When we gather up to go to the mountain road, we go through residential areas, right? So we go out to the spot at midnight. We should at least try to be quiet, even though the car is a loud exhaust. At least, we should have those kinds of manners. Because I live in Japan, the feeling I get when I see the kids is that they don't have the discipline to study what they like. If it concerns the things they like, no matter how much time it takes, even cutting into sleep time, I think they should make the effort to do so anyways. The kids today don't even have that. They think it's as easy as asking somebody. They won't find out on their own. Things that you hear from other people get forgotten as time passes by. Things that you worked hard to find out stay in your memory forever. I don't see the effort anymore. If you drive a car you love, the mechanical aspects of that car should be something that you work hard to learn. I think that's what's missing. Not investing a lot of time into the things you love, but rather choosing the easy solution all the time, is what I feel is happening. It pisses me off. Copy products are also really a big problem in Japan. In Japan, just because it's copied doesn't mean that it's low quality anymore. In the end, it's just like being a thief. I would use somebody's design, in essence, steal it, and then make copies and sell it at a cheap price. So, put simply, I wish that a true car enthusiast wouldn't use fake products like that. I've been participating in drifting events since I was 20 years old. 11 to 12 years. I've been a D1 driver for 3 years. I didn't become a D1 driver because I wanted to be. Whatever I was doing in the past connected me to become a D1 driver. If I was only thinking about becoming a D1 driver, I wouldn't have made it. My fundamental thinking is always to have fun with cars. So, to have fun with maneuvering, to have fun with dressing up the cars, to have fun with tuning the engines, there are so many ways to have fun. To become a D1 driver, at least for me, was an extension to having fun. If you want to become a D1 driver, don't practice so much that it's not fun. I hope you have fun with practicing and also with cars. To build a drift car, the base of the car has to be FR with LSD. The LSD has to be a mechanical LSD. That's the basics to have fun. The rest of the setup is up to your skill level. For example, changing coilovers. My recommendation to the beginners, first, FR, mechanical LSD, suspension tuning, exhaust system. Those are the items that I recommend. You might not agree with me about the exhaust system for drifting. I want you to hear the sound of the car too. For example, the opening of the throttle. I want you to hear the sound of the car with different movement. I want you to enjoy those things while you are practicing. So, those four items are my recommendations.
So, why did you choose the Soarer?
The Soarer, I like the style of the car. In addition, there aren't too many people drifting the Soarer in Japan. I don't like doing the same things as other people. I want a different car than other people. The Soarer is fundamentally a luxury car. It's easy to get around town in, and it's meaninglessly large for a two-door. I like that style a lot. That's why I chose that car, but by no means is it good for drifting. I don't foresee myself as a professional driver for the rest of my career. I have a lot of passion for the car as my hobby. Of course, I want to win the race that I'm participating in. But I'd rather have fun than win the race. I'd like to find a way to have fun. With all that, I'd like to see myself winning the race. Last message to you would be, the car is really enjoyable as a hobby. If you use the car improperly, the car can be really a dangerous tool. You should find yourself enjoying the car, such as dressing up the car, and I really hope you can find a way to enjoy your hobby. Cars are a wonderful thing. I want you to play with them more.
Hi. Thank you very much.
Okay, we're still at the company called Suiva. Look at the sign right there. That's how it's spelled. Suiva. Basically, like killing a little bit of time here, and we're gonna go to both yacht parking and also Nagata to see street drifting. Nagata is high speed drifting, approximately 85 to 90 miles an hour. That's where we're gonna go, and let's see what kind of action we can get tonight.
That's called a Verosa Toyota. Comes with a 1JZ motor, 390 horsepower, single turbo. He's all rigged up with the cameras right there. We're going through some of the typical Yokohama City tunnels. I mean, these tunnels go on for miles. Pretty dope. This is all of Mr. Ueno's younger sibling guys. You know, it's like they got the hierarchy in the street racing world where, you know, these guys do anything for him. And then Mr. Ueno's got his superiors like Orido and, you know, and Drift King and those guys. So, you know, he's watching out for them. He just called them, hey, we're gonna run tonight, JDM Insiders in the, you know, in town. Alright, it's 12:30 right now?
Yeah, it's 12:30 right now.
We're about to get ready to go down to the
somewhere around there.
We've got two Toyota Verosas. One is about 400 horsepower, one is about 380 horsepower. But we're sort of in trouble right now. There's Yakuza, or the Mafia, is down at the racing spot right now. What they do is they steal cars and they run into you. They crash into your car. And that's what's happening right now. Or they'll come out with metal bats and they'll bash your car. It's a territorial thing. If you look, they're discussing right now what to do. It happened to them before. We don't want to get bashed up tonight.
Yokohama, the land of Mr. Ueno. We're here, it's 2:30 in the morning, JDM Insider, bringing you the real street racing. We're gonna go around, he's brought together a bunch of his crew, and a couple of other teams are here right now. So we're gonna go interview, check out some of the cars, let's go. And right now he's a D1 driver. He's got his chaser. He's actually driving on the street. Mr. Ueno's gonna go through a couple things and interview him and see what's going on tonight.
Tonight, we brought you out, Takahashi. How are you running?
How am I running? I'll do better if the crowd's larger.
So you run better with a bigger crowd, huh?
I get an unnecessary burst of adrenaline.
Does it spring forth?
I try too hard.
So what about the car? How much power are you making?
About 350 horsepower.
What about the turbo?
The turbo is from HKS.
This is Hirota, one of our younger drivers.
Hello.
He's got that cute cherry boy look going on. But he's a little oily. Is that your car?
Yes.
How is it?
It's heavy.
Heavy? A lot of the Yokohama cars are heavy, though.
The heaviest car has to be mine.
Whatever, this is like 3,300 pounds.
It's over 3,400 pounds. It's the number one D1 car.
So what? Did you do anything special to this?
Of course.
It's not sticker tuned?
No, it's the interior and engine.
I think the biggest question our viewers have is, why Verosa?
Well,
you're not listening to me. To start off, who makes the Verosa?
Toyota.
That's where we are coming from.
Even if it's a Toyota, it's not a Lexus.
Could you simply explain what you have in the engine?
The turbo is HKS GT 337S and a wastegate. Engine only has upgraded cams.
Is this car built for high or mid-level drifting? What kind of car is it?
It's an easy car to drift.
Anybody can do it.
How's it compared to Takahashi's Chaser?
This is an even easier car to drift.
What do you have to say to that?
It's all about how you control this heavyweight car with finesse. It's all about this.
Can he win?
It's all about this.
Hey, check this out. Hey, Touge, how are you feeling, Touge? You feeling good? That was Mr. Hayama's indecent exposure. Please forgive us. What time is it now?
Like 5:30 in the morning, I don't know, something like that.
Yeah, still in the morning. I mean, early morning. What happened at the other place?
At the other place, basically what happened was the bashers came on bikes, as you guys saw. But it turns out that they weren't looking for a fight. They came over and they said, the Yakuza are basically, our bosses are saying, please, disperse, we're gonna get in trouble. So we all left, and now we're at another place called Field. This place opens up at 6 in the morning, so we have about an hour and a half to just sort of kill time.
here at Kazama. It's 6 o'clock. The road is gonna open. This is what I heard. I heard that the stakes are high. If you get caught here, you get your car impounded, your driver's license suspended, and you have a $10,000 fine. Hiro's got a chaise on. He thinks he's a. Actually, that's a really good. I'm a great masanga. You go talk to Hiro.
I need a shade. The sunlight blinds me really bad. My eyes are really
tired, sleepy.
But hey, you know what? Just hearing the sound of exhaust kind of wakes me up. About 75 to 80 miles an hour. It's so fast. So how did I get there? How did this all begin? No matter how I try, I just can't win. The love I feel for you is just too strong. No matter how we try, we can't get along. We'll get married sometime next year. Won't be the beat of something.
guys are coming in at 170 kilometers an hour. These guys are out of control. I am so glad we stayed up. This is what it's all about. The real thing. It's all sunny outside. Mr. Ueno's taking a ride.
Man, that was a great drifting. This is the first time I'm so speechless. Okay.
Speckles all over the camera right here. Is the light's not even on?
Oh, are you sure? Are you sure?
I think I had a little beer too much, but just I think I'm hungry. I'm gonna go eat some dinner.
Oh, Grill Cincinnati. Maybe there's some racers there.
My bitch.
Hello.
See? I can even make him say goodbye.
Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Driving, it was me. I do this video stuff on the weekends.